Hi, and welcome to the 2023.1 release of Intel Graphics Performance Analyzers. I am Pamela Harrison with the Graphics Performance Analyzers team here at Intel. In this video, I will cover the updates and enhancements we introduce in this release. If you've been watching these release videos over time, you know that I show new Intel GPA features as we add each of them. Over the last year and a half, we developed many of these new features in support of discrete GPUs, as opposed to the traditional onboard or integrated GPUs that are part of the motherboard. Now, since Intel has a couple of performance gaming discrete GPUs in the market, and our GPA profiling features have been improving, I want to review some of them. Highlights for this release are metrics pinning in Graphics Frame Analyzer, the DX12 Ultimate features we added in Graphics Frame Analyzer, mesh shader metrics, and DXR attributes, and then System Analyzer's ability to show the load on the performance cores and the efficient cores. In addition, in GPA Framework, we have made some major improvements to stream compression and substream capture. For update 1, we will look at metrics pinning. The amount of GPU telemetry data increased significantly with the release of Intel Arc GPUs from hundreds of metrics to thousands. We are now able to profile much more with GPA, including ray tracing data. However, the huge number of metrics would take much too long to calculate, possibly causing the application to hang. So now we let you choose the values you are interested in. In the Metrics tab, we introduced metrics pinning, where users can pin their metrics of interest and save them to various presets to minimize metrics collection time and improve analysis speed. Depending on your graphics API and the platform where you are doing analysis, available metrics vary. For example, if you are using DX11, you will not have any DXR data because DXR is part of DX12 Ultimate. So, if we have a frame from GPA sample and choose GPU duration for both the X and the Y axes, we will see the most time-consuming call in the frame. So let's look at that one. Previously, where the bottlenecks show, we showed the pipeline stages, but now, with the enormous number of metrics, we only show the top bottlenecks, a red flame for primary bottlenecks and an orange flame for secondary bottlenecks. Clicking on the bottleneck, we see the metrics relevant to that bottleneck, as well as the description. Let me show you how to select and pin metrics and save them to a preset which can be used in later analysis. The original preset, when you first open Graphics Frame Analyzer, includes only GPU duration. Let's add more. First, if you don't want to overwrite the current preset, make a copy of it by pressing the copy icon, then rename it. Find the metrics you want to add and pin them. Click the check mark to save your new list. Here we can see the basic performance metrics. Now, when you use Graphics Frame Analyzer on this platform, this quick analysis preset will be available. For update 2, we have DX12 Ultimate features in Graphics Frame Analyzer, mesh shaders and DXR. Mesh shaders are new in DX12 Ultimate. They replace the traditional GPU geometry processing pipeline, allowing creation of more detailed and dynamic worlds. Two new types of GPU shaders were introduced, mesh shaders and amplification shaders. Intel GPUs fully support these new elements, providing dedicated metrics. Let's see how to analyze workloads with metrics shaders. Here we are using a mesh shader sample from Microsoft, and we'll look at some rendering calls which have both mesh and amplification shaders. We select the dispatch mesh call and select the shader. We then switch to the metrics tab. I can select the quick analysis preset with the basic metrics we just created. However, for mesh shader workloads, I created a different preset that includes mesh shader data. Now you can see pipeline statistics metrics, including the information about mesh and amplification shaders for that call, as well as the efficiency metrics for that call. For update 3, DXR, after capturing a frame from a DXR workload, open the frame in Graphics Frame Analyzer. Open the dispatch raise call so that you can see the details of the call. I created a pinned metric set for DXR with several of the ray tracing metrics. So to understand performance of the call, you can take a look at the metrics and also the ray tracing shaders, the shader code, the ray tracing states, and the performance metrics. For a final demo, we show how GPA System Analyzer can help on the CPU side, specifically with the loads on the P cores and the E cores. These are performance and efficient cores, big and small cores. This two-core system was introduced on our 12th and 13th generation core processors, formerly codenamed Alder Lake and Raptor Lake. We can look at the distribution of work across the cores. We can see the aggregation of the P cores and the aggregation of the E cores. We can also look at each core individually. Adding the frequency tracks, we can see that the P cores have higher frequency, as they should, because they are the bigger cores. Before leaving you, I want to mention some important improvements we have made to GPA Framework, our command line interface tool. You, like me, probably find it annoying occasionally that storage space is limited. Over the last few releases, we have been working on ways to help you minimize your storage needs. With this release, we have made great improvements to two features, subcapture and stream compression. If you retain streams for regression testing, they just sit there in memory, occupying valuable space. And streams can be really big. Well, maybe you have a 500-frame stream from your last release that you want to keep so that you can compare it against new captures. But maybe you don't need the whole set of 500 frames. Maybe there are a couple of 5-frame sequences in that ginormous stream that you need, but you don't need the rest of the stream. Well, now you can subcapture those two segments. This major update improves stability and allows substream capture from a wider range of DXR workloads. This subcapture capability is already implemented in GPA Framework, and we will be adding it to Graphics Frame Analyzer in a future release. In addition to subcapturing a small number of frames from a large stream, we have added full stream compression with the LZ4 compression algorithm. Now, using the subcapture tool or the full stream compression option in the capture layer, you can reduce the size of GPA streams on disk. You can expect to see file sizes decrease most significantly in resource-heavy workloads. This concludes the highlights for release 2023.1. Try out these features and more with our free downloads. For the full list of updates and changes, take a look at our release notes. Thank you for watching. For more information about the Intel GPA 2023.1 release and to download Intel GPA for free, see the links. Remember to like this video and subscribe to the Intel Software YouTube channel for more Intel GPA news and updates.